think you understand just how fast these cars are, but that's by the numbers. Nothing can prepare you for the G-forces they pull in a straight line. Not even throwing yourself out of a plane, which we'll do later. In the meantime, I'm gonna do my best to put their speed into perspective using a benchmark you know well. The fastest sedan in the world from 20 years ago. So how about we race the E39 BMW M5 against the Lucid Air Dream Edition Performance and the Tesla Model S Plaid. And we'll give the BMW a teensy little advantage. Okay, actually, it's a huge advantage. It's a highway speed advantage. That M5 will be doing 70 miles an hour when it flies across the start line and floors it. So let's see what happens over the next 1,320 feet. Place your bets.
Nothing explains the E39 M5 better than this commercial. When the M5 dropped in 2000, it wasn't just fast. It showed its taillights to every sedan ever built, and most sports cars too. Keep that in mind as you watch these two silent killers prepare to show the M5 who's boss. And here it comes at 70 miles an hour, V8 screaming. The second the M5 passes the Lucid and Tesla, its driver will map the pedal, cracking open 8 independent throttles and starting the race.
Again? I'm starting to be convinced this car is never gonna lose a drag race, but really, were you surprised? 1,020 horsepower, plus cheetah mode, plus the sheer determination of 16 Elons. It's gonna win every time, and I personally find that a little boring. What I don't find boring, however, is that the E39 M5 redefined what a fast sedan meant when it was new, and it's still fast today. That's about as fast as a Honda Civic Type R. And by the way, it was only doing 118 miles an hour when across the line. And yet it still got beat by the Tesla. Imagine you're in a really fast car, like, I don't know, an E39 M5, and you're speeding, and you're in third gear, mad at accelerating right past a cop, hiding on the side of the road in a Tesla Model S Plaid. The second you blow by him, he puts down his donut, floors it, and within 1/4 mile, not only does he catch you, he slams into the back of your M5, doing 35 miles an hour faster than you are. That, my friends, is the difference between today's fastest sedan in the world and yesterday's fastest sedan in the world. And then there's the Lucid, which is a posh luxury car that just happens to be fast. But luxury also happens to be heavy, and it weighs 500 pounds more than the Tesla does. It has 1,111 horsepower, and it doesn't have air suspension, so it can't do the cheetah mode. So ultimately, the Tesla is quicker off the line and then keeps pulling, gaining on it by about 1/10 of a second every 10 miles an hour. Still, that thing bangs off a 0-60 in 2.6 seconds. It is the second quickest accelerating sedan in the history of the world. It would leave a Porsche Taycan Turbo S for dead. By the way, it may be behind the M5, but 0.2 of a second later, it blows right by it. Here's the punchline. That thing uses less electricity than a Nissan Leaf. It uses 1/8 the energy of the M5 while making 3 times the power. What a world.
Ugh. Yeah, we all know electric cars have redefined what quick means, but it's about time we find something else that's silent, but can finally dethrone that pesky Tesla. How about gravity? Let's see who covers a quarter mile quicker.
Cruising altitude, 1,320 feet.
3, 2, 1.
God damn it, the Tesla wins again. This time it beat a guy falling out of a plane without a chute. And to add insult to fatal injury, he was at his terminal velocity. Those two cars kept accelerating to their top speed, and he maxed out at a drag-limited 129 miles an hour. By the way, does it need to be said that no skydivers were hurt in the filming of this video? How could he be hurt? He was killed instantly. Duh.